What's up, guys? Jim your Chaos, welcome back. We have a lot to go over and talk about in this video. We are going to discuss all the weapons that are available in Call of Duty World War II and a couple that you may not know about because they weren't actually in the build or in the gameplay, but they are confirmed. We are also going to talk about something that Michael Condrey confirmed yesterday that has never been done in Call of Duty, and it's amazing. But I still have questions. We'll get into that here in a few minutes. And I wanted an excuse to show you guys this raw firing range gameplay. We got the go-ahead to show it. Other people have probably been showing you as well. And it's just me playing around with guns on the new firing range, which is really, really cool. There's all kinds of stuff you can do on here. And you will be able to 1v1 people in different marksmanship contests and things on here while your friends are actually on the firing range watching. It's by far the coolest firing range that we've had today. So let's get into this. Turn on notifications if you would. Click that little bell. So many of you are. You guys have been tweeting me for weeks now. Everybody joining the notification squad. And I can tell. That's what gets me excited. That's why I keep telling you guys in these videos, because I can tell there's more and more people every day that are getting my videos in their sub box because they have notifications on. And they're letting me know. So it's pretty exciting. The channel is doing amazing things right now, and it's all because of you guys. So let's start off with going over the weapon list in Call of Duty World War II and the few weapons that are added that we didn't get to play with. We'll start off with the assault rifles. You already know the M1 Garand is it's the cream of the crop when it comes to the assault rifles right now. It's going to be your standard issue go-to gun, and it was strong. It was not like a normal first gun that could be potentially weak. This thing was good. I think everybody that played with it will agree to that. Then we have the Bar, which I played with as well. Very, very solid, but it did have a little more, obviously it had more recoil. It's fully automatic, but it felt good. It felt really good. And then another one, a fan favorite that we did not get to play with, but it is confirmed, as you guys can see on the screen right here, is the STG-44. That's right. It will be in the game. Call of Duty has a picture of it up on their site. We saw it in the multiplayer reveal trailer, but they did not have it in the build for us to actually be able to play, which was a bummer because I was looking forward to that. And a lot of people were asking me on my live stream yesterday about the PPSH. People are worried it's going to be a DLC gun. I don't know. I can't confirm, I can't speak for Sledgehammer, but I find it very, very hard to believe that it will not be a gun that is available on day one. It's such a classic gun, iconic gun, not just for the era, but for Call of Duty to not have it in the game. So those are the assault rifles right now. Then we get into the SMGs. Once again, we have two that we were able to play with, but we have another one confirmed. So we have the M1928 and we have the MP40, which looks just immaculate. It plays very, very well. I know a lot of people are worried it's going to be overpowered like the old one from World at War, but once again, I've said this a few times, the guns felt very balanced. You could go use SMGs or assault rifle. Well, the sniper rifles are godlike, but LMGs were good. There was people running around with those. I even thought the shotguns were good. I saw a lot of people getting doing work with the shotguns. I know a couple YouTubers said they didn't feel they were, but I mean, I watch people decimate. When you're on maps that are mostly trenches and bunkers, I think that's a go-to gun. But we'll get into those in a minute. So we have those two guns that were in the build. But the grease gun, as you guys can see on the screen, is also confirmed on the Call of Duty site. And we've seen this front and center in the Call of Duty trailer. So three SMGs confirmed. And the grease gun, I want to get my hands on that one. I think that one's going to be a really, really good option as well. Then we go over to the LMGs. We only have two of those. One of them was the Lewis, and the other one was the MG15. Both of them very, very cool looking, iconic World War era LMGs. And we do know that there is a bipod division skill option, which I actually used, that you can mount these on the ground. You can mount them on a wall. You can mount them on a window seal. So it's going to be interesting to see how people play with those. I know the first thing you're going to say is people are going to camp on the ground in the grass with these. But I'm sure, yeah, well, they will. There's no doubt about it. But hopefully there are countermeasures to go up against that. But yes, the LMGs are very, very strong. They're viable. Let's put it that way. Let's quit using strong. Let's just say right now in that build, they were a viable weapon that you could go out and compete with. Then we have the sniper rifles, which everybody wants to know, but we only got the two in the build, the M1903 and the Kar-98K, which is an old school Call of Duty sniper rifle that a lot of people wanted to come back, and it's back. I find it very, very hard to believe that we won't have the Springfield on day one of launch as well. Once again, an iconic gun in that era, and an iconic gun when it comes to Call of Duty, if you go back to Call of Duty World at War and the previous titles before that. So I'm calling it now. The Springfield will be in the game on day one. Then we get into our pistols. The M1911, you knew it was going to be in there. Front and center, it was in the build. And we had three pistols, I believe, in the build. We had the M712, which is a fully automatic, to me, like a machine pistol. It was fully auto. I was kind of surprised. You'll see it in this gameplay at some point. And then we also had the Luger, which was a German pistol. So three pistols. I don't know what else we'll have. Maybe some kind of revolver pistol. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. There's so many options. If you go to Google and you Google World War II pistols, there are a lot of options, so we'll have to wait and see. Launchers, which are what they are, they're launchers. The M1 Bazooka is in there. Everybody knew that. And the Panzerschreck, which was, I believe, the German alternative for launchers. So the launchers are in there. They shoot pretty straight. I tried to use a Panzer to kill the tank in the war game mode until I found out that you can't kill the tank, so I don't really know what its power is, how it can decimate things, but they are definitely in there. Now, melee. Melee is going to be interesting, because we have the shovel, which I used hands-on, got some kills with. But on the Call of Duty website, the ice pick has been confirmed as well. It's going to be pretty neat to see how that was. I'm thinking it's if from the back, you're probably picking them in the back or the back of the head, and you like put your foot in and pull it out. I don't know what the animation would actually be on the front, but that one's going to be gnarly. I really think we'll see different versions of the trench knife, and I don't know what else. I think they're going to get creative. I think we'll have, I don't know, maybe four or five melee weapons starting out in the game, but it's going to be interesting to see. And then finally, before we get into what Condry talked about, shotguns. The Winchester 1897, and the other one's called the Toggle Action, which I don't think is going to be the final name for this, but I could be wrong. It just seems kind of weird. But like I said, I thought the shotguns were viable because the maps they fit for it. Your trench warfare, there's nothing better than clearing out a bunker or a headquarters or a trench than the shotgun. So we'll have to wait and see. You can put incendiary rounds in them if you have that division skill. And those are all the weapons we know of. Now, I want to talk about something that's never been done in Call of Duty, and it is confirmed by Michael Condry. I put up a video, Call of Duty World War II score streak breakdown plus what's missing. And he tweeted back at me, pro tip, shoot the care package parachute once deployed if you want it to crash straight into the ground. Because in the video, I had stated we're going back to old school care packages where they float to the ground. And I talked about in the past with mishaps of you call it in and it gets stuck on a building or stuck on a bridge. And we didn't have those issues as much with the recent Call of Duties because they come down in like an orbital care package or whatever it may be. They come down quickly. But we're going back to old school. But he is saying that you can actually shoot the parachute and get it to drop immediately. So there's a pro tip. But the question that comes to mind immediately for that is, can the enemy also shoot your care package parachute? Because if they can, they can manipulate it to drop somewhere other than where you want it, and they have a much better chance of actually stealing your care package. I don't think that would be fair. I don't think that should be in there, but you guys can let me know what you think about that in the comment section. I think that you should be the only one to shoot it down, but it doesn't stop there, okay? And this is brand new to Call of Duty. Well, that's brand new, shooting the care package parachute and getting it to drop straight to Earth. T. Martin got in the conversation and said, can you do the same defensively if an enemy calls in paratroopers? If you didn't know, paratroopers are a score streak. They are AI-controlled reinforcements that drop down and help your team. Michael Condry replied, you can. We're still tuning the health and the skill level of the troopers and looking at the score streak cost. Check back at beta. So I think we're going to be able to use paratroopers in beta, and they are working on it. But if you are on the enemy team, let's say T. Martin calls in a set of paratroopers and I'm on the other team. If I see that and I look up and they're coming down, apparently, I can actually shoot the parachutes of these paratroopers and make them fall to the ground and immediately die. So I don't know what the balance is going to be there, because paratroopers are going to be a high score streak. So for me to call that in, or him to call that in, and to get ruined by the other team just looking up and shooting the parachutes, and they're just all dead before they even get to the ground, that would be that would suck. So I don't know how they're actually going to balance that, but those are two brand new things. I mean, the paratrooper, you can kill, well, it's not really brand new for the paratroopers, because it would be like taking a rocket launcher and shooting an UAV or a deploy ship or a care package ship. But the fact that you can shoot the parachute down from a care package and make it drop immediately is definitely something brand new to Call of Duty. So there you go, guys. That's a look at all the weapons. That is some firing range footage for you guys. And that is something brand new coming to Call of Duty that's going to add just another layer of strategy when it comes to care package deployment and paratroopers. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you found this video informative, drop a like on the video. Check out all the other Call of Duty World War II videos, and I'll see you later.